Had enough? I know I've had enough. Enough of the career politicians holding us back. I've had enough of made in China. It's time that we get our economy back on track, putting America and American workers first. I'm a lifelong businessman and a conservative Republican who is the best suited candidate in this race to win the general election, to get our economy back to work and create jobs. The coronavirus can kill you, but so can poverty. It's time to get Kansas back to work. It's also time for term limits, and it's time to elect people who work for you, not the special interest. I've had enough of seeing career politicians working for deep pocket lobbyists in the swamp. I've signed the U.S. Term Limits Amendment pledge, and as your senator, I will co-sponsor and vote for term limits of 3 House terms and 2 Senate terms. I moved to Kansas when I played defensive end for the Kansas City Chiefs. I stayed in Kansas, made it my home, and raised my family here because I fell in love with our state. Since my time with the Chiefs, I've spent over 25 years as a successful businessman, employing thousands of Kansans, and served as a Johnson County Commissioner, as well as many other leadership and public service roles. I know how to make tough decisions. I'm not intimidated when faced with big problems. I face issues head on and will always put the needs of Kansas first. Kansas faces challenges. Challenges I am willing to tackle and put the interests of our state first. One of the biggest issues that our state faces, whether it be in southern Johnson County or in Scott City, is reliable broadband internet access. That is vital for everyone from school-aged children and independents to small business owners in Hayes. If we want to be competitive on a global level, our farmers, business owners, and everyone in between needs to have access to reliable broadband internet. When I say we must put America first, I mean it. That means we need to finish building the wall and reform our immigration system. It means that we need to put the needs of hardworking Americans first and move more manufacturing back to the United States. It means we need to reform the VA and do more for our veterans, keep our military strong, and not just say we're thankful for those who have served, but our military, but to show them that's what we mean. Thank you for taking the time to get to know me a little bit. Common sense isn't very common nowadays, so if these plans make sense to you, I ask you for your vote on August 4th. For more information, please visit us at lindstromforsenate.com or follow us on Facebook at Lindstrom for Senate. I've had enough. Have you?